Alright, we are ready to do a skill builder check. Who can tell me the first thing we do in a skill builder check? Morgan. No, we're not searching for main verbs. What's the first thing we search for in a skill builder check? Guys, we've done this like 6-7 times this year. First thing we're searching for. Cheyenne. Not just subject nouns, but any kind of nouns. Okay? You're going to say the name of this, the number of the sentence. You're going to tell me the name of the noun that you find. You're going to tell me the job of the noun. And then you're going to say yes if it is a noun, no if it is not. Do you know what you're doing? Okay, so Brady, we're going to start with you. We're going to work this way and then over to you. Down this way, from you to her, down this way. So when Chase is finished, Brady, you will start over. So kind of the opposite of what we did yesterday. Alright, so let's do the first one.
1, 2.
What's it called? Nope, that's this part. Remember we talked about how it's not the same?
Com.
Yes, com. Noun.
Subject. Noun.
Okay, you're only doing one at a time. So I'm doing number one. And what's it? Compound subject noun, and is it a noun or not?
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Thank you. Do you remember doing this?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's do it a little bit better. Let's go, please. Next.
Noun, yes.
If you have to tell me the exact job, it's not just a noun, it is a what?
Compound noun.
Just say yes. So, if I was doing this, number one, Tammy, compound subject noun, yes. See how it flows. All right. Morgan, you're up. Are we looking for? We're searching for nouns. So you're going to find me the next noun you see in sentence number 4. So what is the next noun in sentence number 4? How about you concentrate on what you're supposed to be doing and worry about that later. What's the next noun in number 4, please? Did you tell me the job? Then you can tell me yes. No, it's his turn. He started. His, then you, then over here. Brayden, go please.
Number 5.
You. Subject. It's not a subject noun. What do we call that? It's not just a subject pronoun either. What's it called? No. There's not more than one. When we have to come up with it, just like we did yesterday, what do we call it? These are all little things we need to make sure we're remembering. It is a subject pronoun, but it is a specific pronoun. Ian, help him out. Understood subject pronoun, because there wasn't one there to begin with. Is this a noun? If I just said it was an understood subject pronoun, is it a noun? So we're not allowed to circle that one. You did, you're marking it out. Let's go on, please.
House. I'll pick up the preposition noun.
You don't have to say noun again. You're finding me the noun, so you do not have to say that. Just say yes if it is a noun, no if it is not. So these are the ones that you should have circled. Who can tell me what we do after we have found those nouns? Morgan? Thank you. Singular or plural? So which side is it going to go on? The left. Same color. You're not changing yet. Go ahead, Morgan, for the first one. Just tell me the name of the word then, please. No, look at the one that's next and tell me what you're going to do with it. Yeah, what's the next thing we find? Common or proper? Common being any ordinary word, proper being capitalized and important. Next one. This goes on the right side. Same color. Speak up so they can hear you. Grab your second color. What's the next thing we do after we have found our nouns and we've told you whether they're singular or plural and they are common and proper? Okay, what do we do next? All right, so now we're going to underline simple subjects or simple predicates. Yes? Number one. Who's next? All right, Mackenzie, in number one, I want you to tell me the simple subject. Remember what we talked about with keeping our things together. Okay, so because these are compound subject nouns, can I leave them with just one being my subject and the other ones just being left out? No, I want to keep them together. So even when I say simple subjects, you're still going to underline all of it, because it is all staying together. Okay? Same thing if it was a verb and had a compound verb. You would keep it all together in your simple predicate. So, because that's a subject I underline it how many times?
One.
Once. Number two. Bailey, I want simple predicate. What's your simple predicate? Which part am I looking for? If I want simple. And shout it, because I keep them together. I'm not going to put the merrily part on it, but but I'm going to keep my verbs that are compound together. So that is my simple predicate. Does everybody understand that?
Yeah.
Okay, keep them together. Three. Fred, let's do simple predicate again. Is burning. See how we kept the helping verb with the main verb? Need to do that again. Since it's a predicate, it's underlined. Two times. Cheyenne, number four, I want simple subject. Wolves only. Underline once. And number five, I need simple predicates. Okay, so that's you. Simple predicate.
Drive.
Just drive. Does everybody see what you need to do with compound parts when we deal with simple subjects and simple predicates? Keep them together. Just like you keep helping verbs with main verbs, you're going to do the same thing with compound verbs or compound subjects. Now, I told you yesterday that we could have an opportunity to have compound object prepositions. Do we in these sentences? But you will. So I'm going to prepare you for when that time comes. You can have compound subject